Hello, today in this video, I am going to explain you about how to install ANSYS products. ANSYS, for your information, is a simulation software which engineers which are in streams of mechanical engineering, civil engineering or chemical engineering generally uses to perform real life simulations on softwares to check how their processes are going to act in real life. In this video, I'm going to take you through the installation, the step-by-step installation for ANSYS product. So all thanks to ANSYS to provide free student version, which we are going to use for this course. So let's start with it. So the most updated ANSYS version as of now is 2021 R1. So there are multiple versions of ANSYS which come every year. There can be two or three. They release these versions as R1, R2, R3, etc. So we'll use R1 as of now. R2 is going to come up in August sometime. So how can you install ANSYS? So free student version for ANSYS is available. You just go on Google and write student ANSYS version, and the first link which should generally appear on for you should be this. So you just click on this and go to their ANSYS website. You should ensure that the website is authentic one. Then you scroll down, you should get this page first. You scroll down over here and you should get the student software ANSYS Student. This module is where you need to download. It has all the required modules such as ANSYS Mechanical, ANSYS CFD, the modeling software, everything is included in the student version. Though there are some limits, such as there are limits related to number of elements and number of nodes you can simulate or process or put for computation. But these details are not required as of now. The limitations are not very high, and you can easily learn the ANSYS software from students' perspective. Industrial perspectives or industrial requirements can vary, and they may require license versions also. You just double click on this or go to the student ANSYS student module, and you should get a page like this. Now you can may check the requirements of the PC, but even on a 4GB RAM PC also these ANSYS are working, and it doesn't require high amount of graphic cards also. So integrated graphic card is also fine. You just click on ANSYS, download ANSYS Student 2020 R1, and it will give you a file to download around 6 GB, and it will be a zip file. So you just download it, and in your downloads folder, you should find a file which is something like this. It is ANSYS Academic Student _ 2021 R1, and it is a compressed zip file, and an approximate file size should be around 7 GB, 6.8 GB to be precise. You need to extract these files. So after extracting in the folder, you should have the list of folders and some application files. You need to find a setup file, which is an application file. You need to open this. So double click on the setup file, and a window which is something like this should appear. There are two things you need to do over here. First, click on I agree. There are no options. If you do not agree, you cannot install. You just need to press I agree. And one thing you need to notice, there is no requirement of any license files. Anyhow, the license is already inbuilt in the ANSYS product for students, and the license products are completely different. So they are not interchangeable. So you just need to press, click on I agree and press next. Here, for installation directory, I recommend you to install in the directory which has highest amount of space available, because the ANSYS, when they are going to perform computations, it will require some extra space also, and the computations files can go up to 10 GB also. So you need to ensure that enough space is available in your drive, otherwise the computation will not work. So you just need to ensure that your C drive, which is recommended drive, should have enough space. Now you go to press next, and it will directly start installing. And at the end of installation process, this window should appear, which has written installation complete, and you did not need to review any information. you just need to press exit. So here the installation of the ANSYS product is complete. Now you can have access to all the modules such as mechanical, APDL, space claim, etc. So we'll now just go through this ANSYS product to check if the installation is properly done. So go to your start menu and find ANSYS 2020 R1, which will be a new folder generated over there. You just down click over there and you should find a list of so many different modules or products which are installed. So they keep on updating every now and then, and there are new and new products coming up. So it will be very tough for anyone to be updated with all the products. There will be a few bunch of products such as Workbench, APDL or mechanical, CFD, Fluent, a parametric module, and that's a combination of 7-8 will be helpful to complete your modeling and designing of parts. So you just need to first start with Workbench. So just click on Workbench 2020 R1 and a window like this should start. It will take some considerable amount of time, maybe 2 or 3 minutes, maybe up to 5 minutes, depending on your system configurations to start it. It really takes some time. And at the end, a window like this should appear. It is a blank window, an unsaved new project should come up. One thing you need to make sure or make a check of is an analysis system is present and such list of modules are available for you, which will have some different modules related to static solid bodies, fluids, coupled static, thermal, modal, electrical, etc. If the license is not properly engaged in or connected with your system, then you will not find analysis system over here. You will only find component system and ACT. So the other, this detailed modules will be absent. So this is a check. If the license is properly connected with the internet, then this analysis system will be present and you will be able to maybe click or double click on it and a new project will be imported over here. So this is a check to how the ANSYS product is properly installed and the license is properly working. And the steps end over here. You have completely installed the ANSYS and it is working properly. So relax as of now. Thank you, ANSYS, for providing a student version again, and a detailed tutorial videos will be coming up soon. Thank you.